My father-in-law built this swing set as a welcome to Fredericton present last fall, and I thought it'd be cool to make a video about it, except he didn't really want to be in a video, so I'm gonna build it again, but a little bit smaller, as 1/4 scale, and here's my lumber. So what's needed is 2 by 6 times 16 foot long, 3 2 by 4s 8 foot long, and 6 posts 4 by 4 times 8 foot long. Now the 4 by 4 posts don't actually need to be cut at all, and everything else is either square cuts or a 62 degree cut on a 2 by 6. Now my father-in-law used a miter saw, but if you don't have a miter saw, a circular saw will do just fine. The angle that they need to be cut at is 62 degrees, which is 28 degrees on here from square, this angle here. And rather than cut this freehand, I'm just going to make a little saw guide by screwing this 2x4 on here. I couldn't quite cut deep enough because this piece of wood hits the motor. So if you make one of these, use a thinner piece of lumber for this. So this part is the one that goes right about here. And my father-in-law used some big carriage bolts to bolt that together. I don't think that's really necessary. I think 6 long deck screws going more than halfway through the post will be more than enough. So here's the plans for the frames, and here's my cut list. Now I need to cut my scale pieces of lumber. Got all my cut lumber here. The first thing I'm going to do is assemble one of these A-frames. That's the A-frames that are on the end like this. Now I need to measure about 50 and a quarter inches down from the top of the post. Of course, this is a quarter of that, and that will fix the angle when I arrange these parts together like this. Now if this was full size, it would ideally be screwed together with 4-inch long deck screws like this. But those are a little bit large for here, so I'm just going to use a brad nailer. Now, next, we need to stand up 2 frames like this so we can put decking in between. But that's actually quite difficult on a full-size swing set on your own. So I'm going to start by attaching this piece on here. And then we'll stand up the other frame. This can be done with one person. And we'll use one of our 2x4s that hasn't been cut yet to temporarily brace that up. And now we'll bring this frame up on a real size one. It is a bit heavy. And we can now clamp this together here. I'll just nail it. And now I can start adding the decking that goes in between. And now I can take this part out. This is the side that the slide will go on, and these are 2x6s so that they're wider this way, which gives the whole thing more stability this way. On the other side is just 2x4s that serve as a ladder for kids to climb up. So that completes this part here. Next, we need to make this A-frame on the end. Now, just like last time, we need to measure down from the top. In this case, it's 72.5 inches, and that will fix the angle for the whole frame. Now, whether you put a second piece of wood on here is up to you. In the materials list, I haven't got a second one on here, but my father-in-law built it with one here, so I'll just add it on here anyways. Now we need to stand this frame up here, next to this part here. And once again, if you're doing this alone, this is kind of difficult, so I'm just going to use a full 2x4 and temporarily attach that here. And now we need to make a 16-foot beam out of our 16-foot 2x6s and put that up here. Except that's very difficult to hoist up there on your own. So the thing to do is to get one up here like this, and then standing on a stepladder, get this one up here and slide it in place. And then the second one, bring that up here, being careful not to tip this over, and bring it up and in place like this, and then screw them together. Now, attaching this beam to the top of the A-frames is quite tricky. You could just attach some extra pieces of 2x4, short ones, to the side like this. What my father-in-law did is he used foot-long carriage bolts. There's the top of it, there's the bottom, and the hardest part with installing these is drilling all the way through this and through this part with a really long half-inch drill bit. And I'm just going to use a regular deck screw instead of a carriage bolt. One quarter scale model of the swing set. Now on the big one, again, there's carriage bolts that hold this together. I don't think that's such a good idea. Actually, cut these off a bit because it's just another place for kids to get snagged on. I also beveled these corners a bit because when this thing goes all the way, sometimes it swings to the side, and that's another place to get caught on. Here's the big carriage bolt going through. These bolts, again, I don't recommend these. And then there is 8 of these 6-inch long eye bolts. So there's room potentially for 3 swings right there, but this saucer thing takes up a lot of width. So we actually skipped an eye bolt here, and then we did the same thing for the swing because we have a bit more room. And then there's room for one more swing on the end with 2 eye bolts overhanging this part here. We got the baby swing right there. And then a slide on this side, and this should come out the right height for a slide, except this swing is actually on the slope, so these posts on here are actually a little bit longer, about 9 foot instead of 8, to bring the swing level. And because the ground slopes down here, that means this slide needs to be a little bit off the ground. So I quite like this swing set design because it's a really simple design, but very sturdy. A lot of these swing sets that you can buy, they're made out of light brown wood. They look very fancy, but having had a close look at some of these, they're really quite flimsy. And this one, the legs won't lift off if you swing all the way up on the swings. And if you want to build your own, here's the dimensions for it. And here's the cut list. If you want a PDF of this, I'm thinking of just charging a few dollars for that, just so you can support me a little bit.